You are able to see the screen, students?
Yes, sir.
Right. Yes, sir.
Okay. The last class we stopped at the derivation of the Gauss law, and the Gauss law states that the total flux that is coming out from the surface is equal to the total charge enclosed within the surface. And the mathematical formula for the Gauss law is psi, or the flux, is equal to closed surface integral of d bar dot ds, flux density with respect to surface, that is nothing but the charge enclosed. This is a mathematical statement applicable to any surface, okay, surface of any shape, and to any charge distribution. That means it can be line charge or surface charge or the volume charge. The same formula is applicable for all the charge distributions. Next, we will see electric field intensity due to infinite sheet of charge. Till now, we have seen electric field intensity due to infinite line charge. Due to the line charge, whatever the electric field intensity is produced, that we have derived. And we have derived the equation for electric field intensity due to charged circular ring. If it is a circular ring placed parallel to the xy plane, then what will be the electric field intensity? And the third one is electric field intensity due to infinite sheet of charge. Okay. Here, this is the infinite sheet of charge placed. Infinite sheet of charge placed in the xy plane. Infinite sheet of charge is placed in the xy plane. If it is placed in the xy plane, then what will be its z coordinate? There is an infinite sheet of charge which is placed in the xy plane. The floor is your xy plane. You are sitting in the room, x axis, y axis, z axis, correct? The floor of your room, the floor of your room is the xy plane. Okay, so on this xy plane, an infinite sheet of charge is placed. Okay, an infinite sheet of charge is placed in the xy plane. Hence, what will be its z coordinates? Z coordinates will be zero, is it not? Because it is placed in the xy plane, z coordinate will become zero. It is not having any z coordinate. That is, z is equal to zero in the xy plane. Then we are considering a small incremental surface ds on the xy plane, a small incremental surface ds on the xy plane, which is having the charge dq. A small incremental surface ds, which has a charge dq. This is at a distance of capital R from the point P where we are calculating the electric field intensity. Okay, this surface ds, it is at a distance of capital R from the point P at where we are interested in finding the electric field intensity. Then the distance between O to P is z. Okay, then the distance between O to P is z, that is missing here. Please make a note of it. The distance between O to P is z. Okay, the same as we did for the circular ring. There also we considered the circular ring parallel to the xy plane. Here we are considering the xy plane exactly on the xy plane. Okay, so the distance between O to P is z. Then this distance is r. This distance is r here. O to this surface is r, the same as that of what we calculated for the circular ring. We can see here for the circular ring what we have done. The circular ring is here, same as this. This is r from here to here. It is r. Okay, and this is z. Okay, the distance between O to the surface ds here is r for the, that is infinite sheet of charge, and the distance between O to P is z. Okay, this is our circular ring that we already derived it, right? This is distance r from O to this surface. Okay, the ds whatever we are considering now, and O to P is z. Okay, right. Then here the normal direction to ds is z direction. Hence ds normal to z direction is r dr d phi. Ds is the area ds, whatever we have considered this area ds, it is its normal to z direction. It is normal to z direction. If it is normal to z direction, then what will be its area? Its area will be r into the radius into dr into d phi. Correct. Try to recollect what we wrote the equation when we were discussing about the cylindrical coordinate system. Here we are considering cylindrical coordinate system because it becomes easy to analyze, to integrate when it is with respect to the angles, right? Hence we are considering cylindrical coordinate system. We can, of course, we can derive the equation in other coordinate systems also, that is in Cartesian and spherical coordinate system, but for simplicity, cylindrical coordinate becomes easier, and hence we are considering the coordinates of the cylindrical coordinate system here for deriving the equation for electric field intensity due to infinite sheet of charge. Now for the cylindrical system, we know that in the z, if the perpendicular z direction is z, this area is perpendicular to z direction. It is perpendicular because if you are placing on the xy plane, it becomes perpendicular to the z direction. It becomes perpendicular to z. This is your xy plane. So z axis will be perpendicular to this xy plane. Z direction will be perpendicular to this xy plane. Hence, what we will get, the area that we are getting is r d phi into dr. Okay, the angle, try to recollect what we discussed in the cylindrical coordinate system. Okay, because of the arc and the angle phi, okay, the due to phi component, what we are getting is the arc length, it is r d phi, and the distance, that is for the radius, it is dr. Hence, the area, total area that we get for the ds when the perpendicular is z, it is r dr d phi. Okay, your test syllabus, right? R dr d phi. That is the area that we are going to get for the cylindrical coordinate system when the ds area is normal to z direction. It is r dr d phi. We are taking from there directly. Again, we are not going to derive that. We are taking directly from there r dr d phi. Okay. So dq is equal to rho s ds. They have given the surface charge density. Rho s is the surface charge density, because as we are considering a sheet of charge, it becomes the surface. So this derivation, we can also say electric field intensity due to infinite sheet of charge or electric field intensity due to surface charge. Both are one and the same, because the sheet of charge that we are considering is nothing but our surface. Yes or no? What is the definition of the surface charge density? Rho s is given by charge upon area. Rho s, surface charge density, is charge per unit area. That is dq by ds. So dq will be equal to rho s into ds. Dq will be equal to rho s into ds. Ds is, we have written here ds, that is r dr d phi, area ds. Normal to z direction, it is r dr d phi. Write it, rho s into ds is r dr d phi. R dr d phi. Therefore, dE bar, our electric field intensity equation, is Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R square into AR bar. Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R square into AR bar. Here it is, dE bar is equal to dQ divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R square into AR bar. So what is dQ here? dQ is rho s R dr d phi, rho s R dr d phi divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R square into AR bar. Okay, I'm just substituting. dq is rho s r dr d phi divided by 4 pi epsilon r square into AR bar. Okay, take it as equation 2. Next, we have to find the distance r and the unit vector AR bar. So as we did for the, that is, charged circular ring. Okay, in a similar way, here also we are finding the distance r. The distance r, what we found out for charged circular ring, and what we are finding for the infinite sheet of charge is same. Okay, because there also we considered the surface parallel to xy plane. Here we are considering the surface on the xy plane. That is the only difference, but they are same. One is on the xy plane, another one is parallel to the xy plane. Hence, what will be the distance? The distance r, if you want to calculate this distance r, then this is our area. From this area, how much will be the electric field intensity at the point P? That we are supposed to find out. We are supposed to derive that. Therefore, as we are considering the direction opposite to the direction of the normal XYZ directions, therefore, this distance from, that is, this DS to O will be minus AR bar. Okay. Or the total length will be from O to DS, it is magnitude is R, direction is minus AR bar. Therefore, we are taking it as minus R into AR bar. Same as that we did for the charged circular ring. then this is O to Z, origin to Z. It is Z AZ bar. Magnitude is Z. Unit vector is AZ bar. It is Z AZ bar. Okay. Therefore, the distance R bar is nothing but it is a summation of this distance. Okay. According to our law of parallelogram. Okay. It is minus R AR bar plus Z AZ bar. R bar vector, that is from DS to point P, it is distance O to P, that is Z AZ bar, plus distance O to DS, that is minus R AR bar. Write it. That is R vector is equal to minus R AR bar plus Z AZ bar. Therefore, what will be the magnitude, students? Magnitude of this vector will be square root of minus R square plus Z square. That is square root of R square plus Z square. Then find out the unit vector. Unit vector along the R bar direction, that is the distance considering from the area DS to point P. It is the distance vector divided by its magnitude. Yes or no? Therefore, we are writing AR bar is equal to distance vector is R bar divided by its magnitude R bar. That is R bar is given by, that is vector is minus R AR bar plus Z AZ bar divided by the magnitude of R, that is square root of R square plus Z square. Square root of R square plus Z square. That is what we have done in the previous equation. Therefore, dE bar will be equal to, see the previous equation, rho s r dr d phi, rho s r dr d phi divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r square. R square is, this is our r, therefore it is square root of r square plus z square raised to 2, square of that into ar bar is this equation, minus r ar bar plus z az bar divided by square root of r square plus z square. Okay. There, whatever we have found out till now, we are re-substituting in the main equation and then we are analyzing. Okay, we are simplifying. R varies from 0 to infinity. What is the range of this R, distance R? It varies from 0 to infinity because it is an infinite sheet of charge. It is an infinite sheet of charge. Therefore, R varies from 0 to infinity, radius, or the distance from the surface DS to origin, it varies from 0 to infinity. Okay, because it is infinite sheet of charge. Then what about the angle phi? The angle phi, it varies from, it's a full angle, therefore it varies from 0 to 360 degrees, 0 to 2 pi, right? Write it. R varies from 0 to infinity, phi varies from 0 to 2 pi. R varies from the radius, the distance R varies from 0 to infinity, and the angle phi varies from 0 to 360 degrees or 0 to 2 pi. Then the important property that we discussed for the charge circular ring, that when it is in this form, that is when we are having the distance minus R AR and Z AZ bar, and the distance between DS to point P is R, then due to symmetrical property, what is happening? The radial components, that is due to positive z axis and minus z axis, okay, that we are finding at this point P, they will get cancelled out. The radial components due to positive z axis and minus z axis that we are considering at point P, they are symmetrical, they are the mirror image. Okay, they are the mirror image. Mirror image means what? Whatever you are seeing on the positive side, the same will be on the negative side. They are identical, equal and opposite in polarity. Okay. Therefore, these components will get cancelled out, and hence the effect of the radial component is zero on the point P, electric field intensity. That is what it is. We are neglecting the radial component. We are neglecting the radial component due to symmetrical property. I have written here, due to symmetry about Z axis, all AR bar components of E bar are going to cancel each other. All AR bar components of E bar are going to cancel each other. Hence, AR bar component is not considered during integration of the electric field intensity. Whenever we are integrating the electric field intensity, we are not considering the radial component because they get cancelled out each other because of the property of the symmetry. Fine. I hope you all are following here, students. Any difficulty up till here? Students? Any difficulty in derivation up till here? I hope everyone are following.
Yes, sir.
Okay, right. What about others? Other students are following? Any difficulty up till here? Any problem in understanding?
No, sir.
No, sir. Following.
Okay, fine. The write the same equation. E bar is equal to with the integrals whatever we have written here. R varies from 0 to infinity and phi varies from 0 to 2 pi. Write it. Phi varies from 0 to 2 pi. Okay, because what we are having here in our equation, if you look back at our equations, we are having dr and d phi. That means we have to take the integrals of r and phi, of r and phi. Okay. Here we are taking the integrals phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi and the one more is r equal to 0 to infinity. Okay, r equal to 0 to infinity dE bar. That is, integrate phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi and r equal to 0 to infinity. Equation for dE bar is rho s r dr d phi, rho s r dr d phi divided by 4 pi epsilon naught, 4 pi epsilon naught into, this is square root of r square plus z square, okay, so into square of that is r square plus z square raised to 1 by 2 into 2. So 2 and 2 will get cancelled out. We get only the term r square plus z square. Is it not? Then we are multiplying that with square root of r square plus z square. That is this raised to 1 plus 1 by 2. Add the powers. If the base is same, we can add the powers. One is r square plus z square. Another one is r square plus z square raised to 1 by 2. That means one power is 1. Another term power is 1 by 2. 1 plus 1 by 2 will be 3 by 2. It is here r square plus z square raised to 3 by 2. Then the remaining term is, the remaining what we are getting here, minus r ar bar we are neglecting. Okay, we are in this equation. Minus r ar bar is neglected because it is a radial component. Because of symmetrical property, radial component is neglected. Hence, we are get use only the z term, z az bar. Write it. Z az bar. Now we have to change the limits. Use the property, mathematical property of changing the limits. So we know that r square plus z square is equal to u square. We can substitute r square plus z square, whatever we have written here, this one, r square plus z square for this r square plus z square. This is our Pythagoras theorem, that is equal to u square. I can write it as r square plus z square is equal to u square. Okay, to change the limits. Now z is constant here. We are considering z constant. Okay, z is our constant here because in the terms you can see there is only dr and d phi. There is no z term. Okay, that z becomes the constant. Then derivate this. Take the derivation of r square plus z square is equal to u square. It will become 2r dr is equal to 2u du. Z is constant. 2r dr is equal to 2u du for changing the limits. Then substitute. R is equal to 0. If you substitute r is equal to 0 here in this equation, r square plus z square is equal to u square, then u will become equal to z. Am I right? R square plus z square is equal to u square. R is 0. 0 plus z square is equal to u square, or z square is equal to u square. Therefore, z is equal to u, or u is equal to z. Correct? And if I substitute r equal to infinity in this equation, r square plus z square is equal to u square equation, if I substitute r equal to infinity, infinity is equal to u square. That means u is equal to infinity. That means for the range from r equal to 0 to infinity, the limits will change from u equal to z to infinity. Yes or no? And for the limits 0 to infinity, the u changes from z to infinity. Use the property of change of limits. Again, rewrite the previous equation. That is, e bar is equal to integration 0 to 2 pi. This equation, integration 0 to 2 pi, integration 0 to infinity. This integration 0 to infinity now will now become z to infinity. I have changed the limits. So it is z to infinity. Write it. U is equal to z to infinity. Rho s by 4 pi epsilon naught. Rho s by 4 pi epsilon naught. Then what will be r into dr? Students, what will be r into dr? What it will be here? R into dr will be equal to how much? R dr. what you will get? Yes, think. RDR is equal to how much in terms of U? 2RDR is equal to 2UDU. So what will be R into DR? RDR is equal to how much?
UDU.
UDU. Is it not? It will be UDU. Write it UDU. RDR is equal to, in the whatever is in the previous equation, RDR. That will become UDU. UDU. Then D phi. Same whatever it is. So D phi Z AZ bar. D phi Z AZ bar. Then in the denominator, R square plus Z square, we have substituted as U square. Therefore, it will be U square raised to 3 by 2. U square raised to 3 by 2. Simplify further. Integral 0 to 2 pi, integral Z equal to U equal to Z to infinity, rho s by 4 pi epsilon naught. Then this is du divided by U square. Du divided by U square. See, here U square into 3 by 2. That is U raised to 2. That raised to 3 by 2. That means it will be 2 into 3 by 2 in the power. So 2 in the denominator and 2 in the numerator will get cancelled. We get only u cube in the denominator. The numerator here is u and the denominator will be u cube. U divided by u cube is how much? U divided by u cube. Here it is 2. 2 into 3 by 2. 2 and 2 will get cancelled. We get u cube. There is u in the numerator and u cube in the denominator. Then what will be the answer? U by u cube.
Yes, n square, 1 by u square.
Is it not? Yes, you are right. 1 by u square. That is du by u square. Du by u square into d phi z az bar. That is integration 0 to 2 pi rho s by 4 pi epsilon naught d phi. D phi keep it as it is. Now then z az bar also keep it as it is. Integrate du by u square. Can you tell me, students, what is the integration of 1 upon u square? Integration of 1 upon u square is how much with respect to
minus
u?
1 by u square.
Exactly. Minus 1 by u. It is minus 1 by u. Correct. You are right. It is minus 1 by u. That is how it is minus 1 by u. Integration of 1 upon u square is, write it in the x raised to n form. That is integral of u raised to minus 2. If it comes to the numerator, it will be minus 2. That is u raised to minus 2. That is x raised to n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. Integral of x raised to n will be x raised to n plus 1 by n plus 1. That is minus 2 plus 1 is minus 1 divided by minus 2 plus 1 is minus 1. Therefore, it will be simply minus 1 by u. That is, we are substituting here integral of 1 upon u square with respect to du is minus 1 by u over the limits z to infinity. Next step, rho s by 4 pi epsilon naught. Next, we are integrating d phi with respect to phi. It is phi. Integration of d phi with respect to phi is phi over the limit 0 to 2 pi, then z az bar, then substitute the limits here, z to infinity. That is minus 1 by infinity, u is equal to upper limit, that is minus 1 by infinity, minus of minus 1 by lower limit z. Minus 1 by infinity, minus of minus 1 by z. What will be this term, students? Minus 1 by infinity is how much? Can anybody tell me? What is the answer of 1 by infinity or minus 1 by infinity? Think.
0.
1 by
0,
sir.
0. 0. Correct. Exactly. It is 0. Good. So 1 by infinity is 0. Because infinity is a very large term. Suppose if you take 1 by 100, it will be 0.01. So if you take 1 by 1000, it will be 0.001, something like this. So if you take 1 by infinity, it is almost approximately equal to 0 only. Correct? Therefore, 1 by infinity is 0, minus into minus is plus 1 by z. Therefore, this term will get 0 plus 1 by z, that is 1 by z. Then the z and z term will get cancelled. And here we get only az bar. Yes or no? 1 by infinity is 0, 0 minus of minus, it is plus 0 plus 1 by z. 0 plus 1 by z is 1 by z. Z and z will cancel. Then what will remain here? Rho s by 4 pi epsilon naught, substitute the upper limit 2 pi. Minus 0, it is rho s by 4 pi epsilon naught into 2 pi z. Sorry, z will cancel. It will be only az bar. That is our next equation. Rho s by 4 pi epsilon naught 2 pi az bar. Z is cancelled out. Z is cancelled out. Rho s by 4 pi epsilon naught into 2 pi az bar. Into 2 pi az bar. Further simplify, friends. A bar is equal to rho s by, here pi and pi will get cancelled. Pi and pi will get cancelled. Then 2 ones are 2 twos are. Correct? 5 and 5 will get cancelled. 2 ones are 2 twos are. In the equation final, what we'll get? E bar is equal to rho s by 2 epsilon naught az bar volt per meter. E bar is equal to rho s by 2 epsilon naught az bar volt per meter. This is our final equation for the electric field intensity at a point P, at some point P, due to infinite sheet of charge. Correct? Due to infinite sheet of charge, the equation for the electric field intensity is rho s by 2 epsilon naught az bar. Now we have to generalize this. Generalize this equation. If we are considering an bar is a direction normal to the surface containing the charge. There is a surface which contains the charge. Normal to that surface containing the charge is, let us say the direction is an bar of the unit vector. Okay. Then instead of az bar, I can write it as an bar. I have generalized. Here, an can be anything. It can be plus az, it can be minus az, correct? It can be anything. If you are considering plus y axis, it can be plus ay, minus ay. If you are considering on the x axis, it will be plus ax, minus ax, it can be. So it can be anything, correct? Therefore, in general, I can write for az bar, e bar is equal to rho s divided by 2 epsilon naught an bar volt per meter. Rho s divided by 2 epsilon naught an bar volt per meter. This is our equation for the electric field intensity, generalized equation for the electric field intensity due to infinite sheet of charge. So all these three are important, students. In the examination, they can ask electric field intensity due to infinite line charge, electric field intensity due to charged circular ring, or electric field intensity due to infinite sheet of charge. All these three are important from examination point of view. Okay. Any doubts here, students, in this derivation? I hope everybody understood. Yes, please. Any difficulty in understanding? Any steps? Anybody not understood? All of you are clear with this derivation?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Other students? Others?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Ankita?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Ankita Atiwali is there? Ruthik?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Ruthik Chopade?
Yes, sir.
Understood, Ruthik? Any difficulty?
No, sir. Clear, sir.
Okay. Ruthik?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear, a derivation, Ruthik?
Yes, sir. Clear, sir.
Okay. Sankalp? Sankalp?
Yes, sir.
Is the derivation clear, Sankalp?
Yes, sir. Clear, sir.
Right. Sanket? Sanket? Sanket Ambar? Is the derivation clear? Suraya Banu? Tejas? Tejas?
Yes, sir.
Derivation is clear, Tejas?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Right. Take one example, students, quickly. We'll solve an example. A line charge of 2 nanocoulomb per meter lies along y-axis, while surface charge densities of 0.1 and minus 0.1 nanocoulomb per meter square exist on the plane z equal to 3 and z equal to minus 4 meters respectively. Find the electric field intensity at a point 1, 7, minus 2. Note down this example and the figure. It's an examination problem, students. It has been asked in examination. Is it noted down, students? Be a little bit fast. Taken, students?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Read the problem. A line charge of 2 nanocoulomb per meter lies along y-axis. That means they have given line charge density 2 nanocoulomb per meter. So it is rho L is equal to 2 nanocoulomb per meter. It is lying on the y-axis. If it is lying on the y-axis, then its coordinates will be 0, y, 0. Yes, 0, y, 0. Then surface charge densities of 0.1 and minus 0.1 nanocoulomb per meter square exist on the plane z equal to 3 and z equal to minus 4 meters respectively. That means on the z axis at z equal to plus 3 meters on the positive z axis, there is some surface and its surface charge density is 0.1 nanocoulomb per meter square. And at z equal to minus 4, that is in the minus z axis, there is some surface at z equal to minus 4 with the surface gas density rho s2 is equal to minus 0.1 nanocoulomb per meter square. Find the electric field intensity at some point 1, 7, minus 2. So there is some point P, I am considering 1, 7, minus 2. Okay. X, Y are positive and Z is negative. So 1, 7, minus 2. At this point P, we are supposed to find the electric field intensity. We know according to the principle of superposition, that is electric field intensity at some point is nothing but summation of the electric field intensities due to different charge distributions. Okay, that is here in our example, electric field intensity at point P is the electric field intensity due to the line charge which is on the y-axis plus the electric field intensity due to the surface charge which is at z equal to plus 3 meters plus the electric field intensity due to surface charge which is at z equal to minus 4 meters. If we take the summation of all these three electric field intensities, then we'll get the total electric field intensity at the some point which they have asked, that is P of 1, 7, minus 2. Okay. Then consider the different cases here. So case 1, rho L is equal to 2 nanocoulomb per meter. Correct? Rho L is 2 nanocoulomb per meter. The line charge which is lying on the y-axis, which is having the coordinate 0, y, 0, its charge density is 2 nanocoulomb per meter. It is a line charge. Note that it is a line charge. That means the charges are lying on a line. Okay. On some line, rho L is equal to, and its surface, its line charge density is 2 nanocoulomb per meter. Okay. It is an infinite charge along the y-axis. As it is lying on the y-axis, of course, it will be an infinite line charge only. And hence, its y component will be neglected. Because we know that when the infinite line charge lies on any axis, right, that axis components will be neglected because they are symmetrical components, mirror image, and hence that axis component will be neglected. Similarly, here also as it is lying on the y-axis, its y-axis component will be neglected when finding the equation or when simplifying the numerical. The equation for the electric field intensity due to infinite line charge is given by E is equal to rho L divided by 2 pi epsilon naught R AR bar. E is equal to rho L divided by 2 pi epsilon naught R AR bar. Any point on the y-axis is 0, y, 0. And we are supposed to find E at the point P of 1, 7, minus 2. As line charge is along y-axis, E1 cannot have any component along y-direction. No need to consider the y-coordinate because the symmetrical component, it will get cancelled out. Therefore, we are not considering y coordinate while calculating AR bar. And what will be the distance r? Distance r between the line charge, which is lying at 0, y, 0, and the point P of 1, 7, minus 2. Destination is point P, source is the line charge. Right? Destination minus source, that will give our distance vector. That is, here it is between 1, 7, minus 2, point P, and 0, y, 0. Y component we are not considering. Therefore, only consider the x and z component. 1 minus 0 into ax bar, then plus of minus 2 minus 0, minus 2 minus 0 into az bar. That is, the equation will be 1 minus 0 into ax bar plus minus 2 minus 0 into az bar, or r bar will be equal to ax bar minus 2 az bar. What will be its magnitude, students? Can you tell me the magnitude of ax bar minus 2 az bar? How much will be its magnitude? How we are calculating the magnitude? Yes. How we are calculating the magnitude, students? Yes, please. What is the equation for the magnitude? Square root of?
Again, x square root, sir.
Yes. Square root of x component square plus square root of y component square plus square root of, correct, z component square. Here we don't have y component. Therefore, square root of x component ax bar, its coordinate, its coefficient is 1, square root of 1 plus coefficient of az bar is minus 2, minus 2 square is plus 4. Therefore, it will be root 5. Ar will be equal to the distance vector divided by its magnitude. Then write the equation for electric field intensity, that is rho l divided by 2 pi epsilon naught. Rho l is given 2 into 10 to minus 9 divided by 2 pi into epsilon naught is 8.854 into 10 to minus 12 into, what is the equation, into r, r is root 5, into in the numerator ar bar. AR bar is R bar, that is AX bar minus 2 AZ bar divided by magnitude of R, that is square root of 5. If we simplify this, students, then we should get this answer. Please simplify this portion. 2 into 10 to minus 9 divided by 2 pi into 8.854 into 10 to minus 12 into root 5 into root 5. Simplify that and tell me how much you get. Final equation, you please tell me in terms of AX bar and AZ bar. Numerator, you note down these steps quickly, then calculate this. 2 into 10 to minus 9 divided by 2 pi into 8.854 into 10 to minus 12 into root 5 into ax bar minus 2 az bar divided by root 5. Simplify quickly. Is your answer matching, students? Yes, tell me. Yes. Come on.
Correct, sir.
Correct, no? Okay, fine. Yes. Good. Okay. Note down this equation, students. Final equation. E1 bar is equal to 7.19 AX bar minus 14.38 AZ bar volt per meter. Okay. This is our equation. Then next, we are considering case 2. What is our case 2? Case 2 is due to this surface charge or the sheet of charge. Okay. That is, rho S is 0.1 nanocoulomb per meter square at z equal to 3. Okay, let us find out that. Rho L is 2 nanocoulomb per meter infinite, that is rho S. 1 is 0.1 nanocoulomb per meter square along z equal to 3. Normal direction to z equal to 3 will be in the minus az axis. Normal to this surface will be minus. Why it is minus? Because we have to consider point P. Point P is here. 1, 7, minus 2 is z. Z is minus 2. Therefore, along the other direction towards the point P, it is minus az, minus az. Okay, therefore our an bar will be minus az here. An bar will be minus az bar towards the side where P is located. Therefore, the equation for E2 bar will be rho s1 divided by 2 epsilon naught En bar. This is just now we calculated, derived the equation. Electric field intensity due to infinite sheet of charge, that is rho s divided by 2 epsilon naught En bar. Rho s is 0.1 into 10 to the minus 9 divided by 2 epsilon naught is 8.854 into 10 to the minus 12 into En bar is minus Az bar. This will become 5 minus 5.6471 Az bar volt per meter. Note down this quickly, students. Make it fast. So for homework, students, take the case 3, try to find out the case 3. Okay, then we will discuss in the next class. Okay, try to do for the case 3. That will be your homework. Did you all take down, students? I hope you have noted down, students. Yes. Students, are you here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So please do it for okay. Case 3, then we'll discuss in the next class. Okay. Then find the resultant of all those three, so that we'll discuss in the next class, right? I hope everybody followed. Yes, students, any difficulty here? Students, any difficulty? Adar Shinde, any difficulty? Lohit?
No, sir.
Okay.
No, sir.
Kirti? Okay, fine. Kirti, any difficulty?
No, sir.
Kirti? Okay. Karthik? Karthik?
No, sir.
Okay. Tejas, any problem in understanding Tejas? Tejas, Agasar?
No, sir.
Okay, fine. Then we'll continue in the next class, students. Okay, good. So please do it for homework. Then we'll discuss in the next class. Okay. Thank you.